Movies are probably my main source of inspiration, in both what I do for work, as well as in my own personal life. I have watched movies for as long as I can remember, and to this day, it is still one of my favorite things to do. The one that changed my life was The Lord of the Rings back in 2001, when I started to understand what happened behind the camera, and from that day, I was hooked. That movie influenced me so much that I first moved to Australia to be close to New Zealand. Movies have influenced me as a filmmaker, and had an impact on the person that I am, whether it was for the stories, location, and soundtracks. But today I want to focus on the ones that influenced me in the recent years and changed the way that I shoot, and the ones that made me a better shooter, and hopefully you can take something out of it too. So today, I'm going to talk about 5 movies to improve and inspire your cinematography. There are so many movies out there, and it would be hard for me to come up with the top 50, let alone with the top 5. The movies that I picked today are the ones that I either look up to from a cinematography point of view, but also the ones that change the way that I compose and think about a scene. This is not an essay or a cinematography breakdown, but more what I like about them, whether it is their composition, style, movement, and why I keep coming back to them for inspiration. This is Flying from After Lens. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe, and let's get into it. So the first one on my list is Macbeth. Directed by Jerzy Kurzel in 2015 and shot by Adam Arkapo, Macbeth is a title that I usually give to people when they ask me what is my favorite film when it comes to cinematography. Each frame is as beautiful and carefully crafted as the next one. I've always loved period pieces, and this one adds to it by bringing a strong visual style that in my opinion puts it in a different category. The King, released on Netflix, is very similar in that sense. And it is not surprising that it was also shot by the same cinematographer. Macbeth uses a mix of strong color themes, extreme slow motion, soft and practical lighting, but also high contrast imagery to create an immersive experience. The cinematography is stunning, whether it is a wide landscape shot or a close-up on someone's face. I have rarely seen a film with such a strong and distinct cinematography. Of course, this movie is extremely stylized, and you will need a lot of experience and a large crew to achieve this look, but cinema is also about escaping and diving into a story, and to me Macbeth does an incredible job at that. Out of the 5 movies that I talk about in this video, this is probably the least known, and I highly recommend it that you give it a watch. Number 2 is Moonlight. Directed by Barry Jenkins and shot by James Laxton. When I first saw the trailer for the first time, I knew that this was going to be a unique film. I tend to always gravitate towards drama and serious movies rather than comedies, and there are a lot of reasons why I love this movie, apart from the story, impeccable acting, and a beautiful score. First is the energy. I love the way the camera follows and moves around the characters. Most of it is shot handheld, and you know I'm a big fan of handheld work, and Moonlight is a perfect example. Handheld and shaky when it needs to be, and stable when it doesn't. Color palette. When I think of Moonlight, I think of the poster with the very distinct hues, which are reflected throughout the film as well. Composition. I found that a lot of the time the subject is in the center, either we're following or we're confronting, and also love the use of close-ups, which I found very effective in a lot of ways for such an emotional film. This shot of Naomi Harris screaming is extremely powerful. Anamorphic. I've never myself shot anamorphic, and I think sometimes it is overused these days, but in a movie like Moonlight it just works. The bokeh and the soft edges create an aesthetically pleasing image without being too distracting. My favorite shot is probably the one of Black, aka Chiron, in the bathroom. I find it hard to explain, but this shot stays with me, and every time I think about composition, this shot comes to mind. Raw, intense, and beautiful. If I had to describe Moonlight, these would be the words that I'd choose. The third one on my list is Call Me By Your Name. Call Me By Your Name is one of those movies that rely on script, emotion, acting, and location, rather than expensive sets or visual effects. Shot on film with a 35mm lens only, there is something special about how this movie draws you in this summer holiday through the eyes and feelings of a teenager. The cinematography is organic, authentic, and it makes for a very unique and somewhat fresh experience. We are bombarded these days with blockbusters and superhero movies that going back to the basics feels strangely satisfying. Director Lucas Guadagnino and cinematographer Sayombu Mokdiprom did an incredible job in creating a movie that is so beautiful in its simplicity. To me, Call Me By Your Name is a perfect example of less is more. Although I'm French-Australian, my grandfather is Italian, and this movie takes me back to some of the villages that I heard so much about, or to the places that I used to visit as a kid. It is a movie that stays with me because it is real. As humans, we can relate to the emotions that these two characters are going through, since one way or another, we experience something similar in our lives. I have rarely been moved as much as when watching the last scene of this film. My wife and I have loved this so much that we actually used the soundtrack for our wedding. Next is The Revenant. This movie, directed by Alejandro Iñárritu, and a few other ones from Terrence Malick, is one of the reasons why I find myself shooting wider more and more. If you're familiar with my work, you know that I love shooting handheld and capturing the quiet moments, whether it is when exploring new places or for actual proper projects. And in recent years, I have done so using wider lenses than when I first started. Shot by Emmanuel Lubezki, the cinematography creates an atmosphere and feel in The Revenant that is so captivating, you can really feel the cold and vastness of the landscape the characters are in, or the feelings and emotions that they are experiencing. Having read the book, I found the movie to be more effective in conveying the harshness of the environment. I find it really hard not to be thinking about this movie when I'm walking through a forest or looking up at trees. Another big reason that I love this movie and keep coming back to it is the fact that it was shot almost entirely with natural light only. Again, if you follow my work, you know that most of my work is done using natural light. I use this movie to get inspiration for travel when going to wild places or when documenting a subject in the woods or outdoors. And the last one is Arrival. Denis Villeneuve is probably my favorite director. From Incendies to Prisoners or Blade Runner 2049, I found that his movie is to sit above so many others due to how he manages to take a common genre, such as action, war, or crime, and elevate it to something that we are not used to. To me, Arrival is a perfect example of that. It is a quiet and personal sci-fi movie. Shot by Bradford Young, Arrival is an intimate movie featuring aliens, spaceships, and elements that you would normally find in a more action-packed film. Despite the gravity and seriousness of the plot, Arrival is a calm and measured movie. The camera is often still or with very minimal movement, except when showcasing flashbacks of a happier or more carefree time where the movements feel more like a documentary. And of course, during the action scenes. Most of the time, the film has a dark, cool, and desaturated look that make it look very real. I love how deep the shadows are and how it makes the orange suits pop, for example, and how the color contrast is used inside the tents. I also find it very interesting that an international trailer has more of a blockbuster approach to properly appeal to a larger audience, when in reality it is far from being your typical sci-fi movie. I often think of Arrival and how it does a great job at subverting our expectations when it comes to alien movies, and how an intimate approach to camera work can also work for this genre. A lot of the action actually happens inside, and I found this film to be a great example of shooting in the same space, using multiple angle and different composition techniques to keep the scenes interesting. That's it for me today, guys. Hopefully you have enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe and let me know in the comments what are your favorite movies to find inspiration. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.